Jeff Little with Wilderness Systems Kayaks at the 2013 Outdoor Retailer Show. Gonna walk around here and check out some of the other booths and show you some of the products that I use and maybe some that I'm in the market for.
Hi, I'm Steven with Cocotat. I'm here showing off the Hydra Supernova Angler Suit. This is our fishing-specific paddling suit. It features our Hydra's three-layer material. It's a waterproof, breathable three-layer fabric. Similar to Gore-Tex, waterproof, breathable, lifetime warranty. The suit has waterproof zippers, relief zipper is covered. The neck gasket is a nice, comfortable neoprene gasket, latex wrist gaskets, and Hydra's material socks, so the suit stays completely watertight aside from the neck. Cordura reinforcements on the seat and lap, covering the relief zipper, as well as on the elbows for doing work with fishing lines and hooks and cleaning your catch.
So last week on the Chesapeake Bay, I actually broke my 15-year-old cart. The strap right in here snapped somehow. So I'm here with Kevin Henderson. He's going to show us three of the Harmony carts that we got, and maybe help me pick the right one.
So we've got the smaller boat cart here that's actually collapses up, and you're able to actually fit into some of the hatches of the boats. You can take the pins off on these as well too. And then we've got the bigger boat cart that's a little bit bigger for holding some of the bigger boats. And one of the things I find is a lot of times we're fishing at a sit-on tops, and you've actually got the different hulls that sit on here and kind of slide around, and you got to put a strap on to try and keep it on. So one of the new ones that we've got now is the Harmony sit-on top fishing cart, and it's a scupper mount. So the nice thing about these is that these bars actually ratchet in and out to slide into your scupper holes on the back of the boat. So what I do is I usually line these up to my scupper holes, and then I'll simply, you can tighten up this strap here so these can't move around. I'll actually tighten these up a little bit too so these can't still ratchet around, and slide them in. Your boat goes on there ready to go. These are padded so that they fit into the holes really nice, and then they kind of just cantilevers up against the boat. So once I throw my sit on top onto this, it's ready to go. I don't have to put a strap or anything on, all my gear's on, ready to go. And the other thing we've got here is we've got the flat free. These are a foam filled tire, so they're never going to go flat. They're actually quite solid, and all you do is just flip the little clips off on these, and you can pull the tires off as well too. So super simple. You can break this down if you want. On the sit on top, if you don't have a milk crate or something in the back of your boat, when you're done, what you can do, you get down to the water, you can pull this out, just going out for a few hours, flip this upside down, and I'll drop these into the top side of the scupper holes as well to pull my shock cord over, and I'm ready to go. So a great way to go, not worried about straps or anything. Fantastic cart from Harmony Gear.
Hi, I'm Mike Winiger from Terrain Outdoor Products. We're the makers of retractable gear tethers, and included in the retractable gear tether is our new Pro Sheath. Built-in retractor, 36 inches of extension, brings back your pliers, nice custom fit sheath, protect your pliers, multi-purpose attachment in the back, belt loop or stainless steel clip. Aircraft aluminum handles, stainless steel tips, carbon tungstide cutters, great for cutting steel leaders, braided line. Internal springs are all stainless steel, so it will not weep rust as most other ones will.
Luther here from Yak Attack. I'm here with the new Zooka tube, and we're going to show you guys how this thing works. So one thing we knew we wanted a tube style rod holder, but a lot of tube style rod holders, they have a bottom in them, so rods with long rod butts can be a little bit problematic. So what we've done here is we've created an open end tube design, so regardless of whether you have a really long rod butt or a shorter rod butt, it's going to go right into the rod holder just fine, and you're not going to have the bottoming out issue. The other thing we wanted to do is we wanted to have the rod holder really secure, but we didn't want it to be complicated. We didn't want moving parts. So if you take a look here, I'm pulling on this just about as hard as I can, and it's because this little groove here for the trigger. And when a fish is pulling down, he's just making the rod even more secure. But your natural position to take this thing out, you lift it right out, and it's pretty effortless. So that's the conventional side, the bait cast side. And then for the spinning reels, we just loosen the knob on the side, and we rotate it 180 degrees to the other end. And again, this can be used like a conventional tube, but here we've got features that are designed for the spinning reel. So the neck, You just rotate it, drop it down in the slot, and then once again, you've got a secure rod. It can't get pulled out. You don't have to worry about brush or a fish or anything else pulling it out. And once again, no moving parts. So that's the functionality from that standpoint. The other thing that's pretty exciting is a lot of people are familiar with Ram's ball and socket mount. This product is something we co-developed with Ram, so it's sitting on the Ram platform. But what a lot of people are not familiar with is Ram's post and spline. So if we take a look here, here's a Ram deck mount. It's got a plunger base. You just pull the plunger to release it. It's post and spline. So for your heavy trolling applications and things where you want to make sure no matter what, you don't get any slippage, this is going to take care of that. And because they both use the same Ram ratchet interface, you can interchange parts. So with one rod holder and two arms, feasibly you can have two completely different systems for two completely different applications. And this is not only true for the Zooka tube, but all of the other Ram rod holders that have the same ratchet interface and the extenders and everything, they all can be interchanged as well. So two products you definitely want to check out, the Yak Attack Zooka tube on the Ram platform and the Ram post and spline mount.
I'm here with John DeMason, who covers Harmony Gear, a lot of the accessories we use on our kayaks. And she's got an interesting product for milk crates, is that right?
Yeah, we're bringing in this particular product in the line this year. It's from Mad Frog Gear, and it's called Crate Rails. And it works directly with a milk crate, just any kind of milk crate that you might be able to get out there, preferably heavy duty. It's very similar to our dashboards in that they are pre-drilled with a number of holes. You can see that unlike some of our other dashboards, it has larger holes. And the way that it works is it comes with the hardware, has two different positions for the milk crate, and once you screw them down onto the, as I said, it uses a heavier duty milk crate, then you've got a couple of different options on how you might want to outfit it for the back of the boat. You see these circles right here perfectly fits PVC pipe, so once you put the PVC pipe in there, it can work as your two rod holders. There's a circular cutout here that will perfectly fit many of the, I believe it's 3 gallon bait buckets. So you've got your live minnows or whatever it is that you'd like to take out there on the water. The little holes here on the top will perfectly fit the Scotty and Ram mounting systems, as I believe it will also fit a Yak Attack Mighty Mount. And then you see once you've got these particular pieces sitting out on the side, it will accommodate any of the tools that you brought out on the boat, some pliers, whatever it is, and two additional holes for PVC tubes. So you're going to have the ability to have two rod holders, all of your tools, mounting for any rods or rod holders, I should say. And then one really unique item is that it has these little insets on the side here, and that's going to allow you to bungee down everything that you've got here on the back of the boat, and that's those little holes right here. So great new accessory that's inexpensive to add to your milk crates, and it's going to allow you to basically take everything out of your car directly to the back of the boat, put it right on the back, get you out in the water quicker, and then back home again. So that's the Mad Frog Crate Rails.
On my plane right here to Salt Lake City, this was my carry-on bag. I carry this bag everywhere I go. It's made by a company called Watershed, and I keep all my camera equipment in here. And I'm here with Sean from Watershed. He's gonna go over this bag and then one other bag that might be good for those of us that like to camp on the river.
Hi folks, this here is our Akoi. This is our standard small duffel. The beauty of this bag is it is nice and small, but also because of our patented Ziploc enclosure, you do not have to roll this bag down. You can actually leave it fully open like this and still get the same water protection, still guaranteed down to 100 meters. So the nice thing is if you have a little bit extra space you need, you can use this full compartment. But if you need a nice, tight, small bag, maybe to stow on your kayak or just kind of have a small, not going to be too big, not in the way, roll it down. You got a nice small duffel. These ones retail for about $97. We also have something we like to feature here. This is more of our multi-day pack. This is another duffel, same kind of design, same body type and everything. Only big difference is you got about 400% more room. So the same deal, you can take this guy if you do need the extra space. Again, the Ziploc is guaranteed. This is what actually keeps the bag dry. It does not need to be rolled down. So if you have that big trip coming, you can stack even more stuff inside. I use this personally for about a 3 to 4 day trip. It's good. What I actually personally do is I use a smaller liner inside, keep my good, my clean clothes on one side, dirty clothes on the other, be able to switch it out, that kind of thing. But this is a perfect bag for anybody who's looking to do a couple nights overnight on the river. Perfect bag. Absolutely. Most important thing, first thing you'll see is these tabs right here. It kind of makes you feel like you're just supposed to pull them off like this, but that's not what we recommend. What'll happen is you'll end up pulling these off over time. These are here really to kind of guide your hands and allow you to do an S-curve that once you kink it to this point, nice and easy. This is our patented enclosure right here. One thing I like to recommend to people is it's very important to keep this lubricated. This is the lifeline of your bag right here. If this ends up drying out, you're not gonna be able to close it out and actually get your waterproof seal. So we do recommend you take care of it. We do recommend 303 as the product to do so. So these are guaranteed for life to the bag, which means you don't have to prove you bought it. You don't have to do any sort of paperwork, nothing like that. We know our product. If you have any sort of issues whatsoever, bring it back to us. We'll take care of it.
Hello, my name is Colin Malone, and today I'm going to talk to you about our Microsport trailer, which is perfect for the everyday kayak fisherman. Well, first of all, it's a good thing to know that this is completely outfitted with all of our bells and whistles. We are here at a trade show, so we are showing everything that we have to offer. Some nice features that our trailer has right off the bat. Is a 65-inch load bar, which comes standard, or a 78-inch load bar if you want to put two wider kayaks side by side. When it comes to the load capacity, we're right around 350 pounds. However, there is a double leaf spring that we can upgrade to close to 800 pounds, which is a little overkill, but you never know. Right here, you'll see that the tongue, which is an 8-foot galvanized tongue, is retracted back into the body of the frame. That helps take a 13.5-foot trailer and brings it down under 7 feet. Really nice for storing, and also if you just want to dolly it around the driveway, it's a lot easier to do so. As far as accessories go, we have a full line of kayak carriers. We have 4-point saddle systems that work great for the sit-on-top boats, and we also have J-style carriers, which are a little more common on the market because they take up less footprint across the bars. But either one would definitely work for your kayak.
Wow. Any of you guys that have seen my my YouTube videos in the summer, seeing me wear a big wide brim hat, that's the Kokatat Sunwester. There's been some updates to it. Matt here with Kokatat is going to go over some of the upgrades.
So this is our new Sunwester. We used a new fabric. We're using a polyester dobby fabric now. That's a lighter weight fabric, and it's a UPF 30. And we've redesigned the top of the hat, so there's actually these flip-up vents. So if you need more ventilation, you can flip those up, and then you can flip them down for more sun protection. We also made the brim pattern a little wider, and the brim is a floating brim. It's still got an adjustable draw cord back here. And then you've still got your chin strap and then a really nice wicking band around the base here. So it comes in two colors and two sizes, and that's the new Sunwester.
I'm here at the Smart World booth, and those of you who have seen my winter kayak fishing videos know that that's one of the products I really firmly believe in. Especially, you know, when there's ice on the river, you need a good one single pair of super warm socks to, you know, keep you out there on the water longer. And Smart Wool is the sock that I've been in, I guess, the last 5 or 6 years. So I'm here with Shelby, and she's going to tell us a little bit about Smart Wool socks.
Hey folks, I'm Shelby. I'm from Smart Wool. For those of you who have not tried Smart Wool, we're all a merino wool brand. Our socks are great for year-round, as Jeff has experience. So whether you want to fish in the summertime or year-round with our mountain trekking, outdoor socks for the wintertime, it'll keep your feet warm, it'll keep them dry. Biggest things for the outdoor industry. They are the most durable socks, especially our new PhD line with our outdoor socks. We actually have a patent technology on the socks that keep them extremely durable. And again, It'll just keep your feet fresh, warm, and they control your odor. So your wives won't be freaking out when you come home and take your boots off.
Here with Rick Burnley, my editor with Kayak Angler magazine, and he's going to tell us a little bit about the changes they've made with the magazine.
Yeah, Jeff, thanks for giving us an opportunity to show off the magazine. If you've noticed, of course, this year one of the biggest changes we've made is we've gone to a larger format, and in the spring issue we had this UV cover, and we're going to go with that UV cover for the next four issues. I said four issues, that's right. We're adding in a fourth issue, working on it right now. It'll be the first winter issue of Kayak Angler magazine, so now you get it four times a year. We've also revamped the website, as most people probably already noticed. We've got all the rapid media publications on one website, so you've got Adventure Kayak, Canoe Roots, and Rapid Magazine under the same title as under the same headline as Kayak Angler. So we're excited to have all these titles together. We've expanded the forum. The blog is ripping it up, and so we're really excited. We got a lot of changes, and we're stoked to see what we got.
Sure.